Namaste, welcome to the session Design of Demultiplexer Tree. At the end of this session, students will be able to design a demultiplexer tree. Now before proceeding further, we have already discussed demultiplexer. So take a pause here and recall what is demultiplexer. So multiplexer is also a combinational logic circuit which distributes a single input binary information to one of the 2^n number of output lines using n number of selection, or also known as control lines. Demultiplexers are also known as data distributor because it distributes the same information to all of the output one by one. It has exactly reverse process of multiplexer. So this is the block diagram of 1:n demultiplexer, where you can see there is a single data input line and 2^n data output line, whereas we have n number of select lines which selects one of the output which is get connected to the input line, and hence the data is get distributed among all of the outputs. Applications of demultiplexer. Demultiplexers are most widely used in communication field. So along with multiplexer, demultiplexer are both used in communication field. In serial to parallel data conversion, to produce the parallel data from incoming serial data stream, demultiplexers are used. Demultiplexers are also used to design combinational logic circuit, which is very easy to design. Demultiplexers are used in arithmetic and logical unit to store the data in multiple registers. Now let us see design of multiplexer. So let us have an example of 1:4 demultiplexer. So very first step is to draw the block diagram. So as we know that we have to design 1:4 demultiplexer, it means that we have single data input and four output lines. So we have to find out how many select inputs are required. So there is a formula 2^m is equal to n, where m select inputs are there and n number of data outputs. So we know that in 1:4 demultiplexer, so n is 4 data outputs, so we require 2 select inputs, so m becomes 2. So let us draw the block diagram. So here input, single input is there denoted as I, and 4 outputs are denoted as y0, y1, y2, y3, and 2 select inputs are denoted as s1 and s0. So in our truth table, we include all these inputs along with outputs. So I is a single input where it may be 0 or 1, or it may be stream of 0s and 1s. So here we have select input s1 and s0. So based on s1 and s0 combination, we have 4 outputs. So let us consider I may be 0 or 1. So when s1 and s0 both are 0, 0, then y0 is get selected and others are not selected. So here input is get connected to the output y0. When we have s1 0 and s0 1, then again I may be 0 or 1. Now this time y1 is get selected, so input is get connected to y1 here. When s1 is 1 and s0 is 0, then according to the truth table y2 output is get selected. So here the input 0 or 1 is connected to the y2 output, and when s1 and s0 both are 1, 1, when input I may be 0 or 1, then it is get connected to y3. In the next step, we are going to write logic equations for all the outputs of demultiplexer. So here in 1:4 demultiplexer, we have 4 outputs y3, y2, y1, y0. So the equation here for y0, we are getting y0 when s1 and s0 are both 0, 0 along with y. So equation becomes y0 is equal to s1 bar s0 bar I. Then y1, we are getting y1 because when s1 is 0 and s0 is 1 along with I. So y1 becomes s1 bar s0 I. Similarly, y2 equation having y2 is equal to s1 s0 bar I, and y3 we are getting when s1 and s0 both are 1, 1 along with I. So y3 is equal to s1 s0 I. In the next step, we are going to draw logic circuit for 1:4 demultiplier. So to draw logic circuit, we require equations of output. So based on these four equations, so four AND gates are giving four outputs as y3, y2, y1, y0. We have common single input data line, that is I, and s1, s0 are select lines. Now let us discuss how to design demultiplier tree. A larger demultiplier can be implemented using a tree of smaller demultipliers. So let us have example here to construct 1:4 demultiplier using 1:t demultiplier. So here we require two numbers of 1:2 demultiplier, two select inputs. So in 1:4 demultiplier, we have y0, y1, y2, y3 outputs, and here we are considering D in as data input. So this is the block diagram construction of 1:4 demultiplier using 1:2 demultiplier. So this is the first 1:2 demultiplier, and this is the second 1:2 demultiplier. So each one of these demultipliers giving two outputs. So total we have four output, but these having individual input, so there will be two input. So these two inputs are combined together and made single input line denoted as D in. Then we are using S1 and S0 select inputs. S1 is used as a enable input. So one of the demultiplier is get enabled at a time. Then S0 is used to select one of the output of each of these two demultiplier. Now let us see how it works. Now consider that input is already there. DIN input is distributed to the DIN input of both 1:2 demultipliers. So when S1 and S0 are 0, 0, so this S1 0 is converted to 1. So whenever one input is given, the first demultiplier is get enabled, and because of that, second demultiplier is get disabled as E2 having here 0. Then due to the S0 as it is 0, the first output of each of these demultipliers are get selected. As second demultiplier is already disabled, so the DIN input is directly connected to the Y0. So in the second case, when S1 is 0 and S0 is 1, so in this case also, due to this S1 0, the first demultiplier is get enabled and second demultiplier is get disabled. So as S0 is 1, but here first demultiplier is enabled. So we are getting input connected D in to the Y1. So in the next case, S1 is 1 and S0 is 0. Due to this 1 as S1, it becomes 0 to E1. So first demultiplier is get disabled, and due to this 1, the second demultiplier is get enabled. So when S0 is 0, so in this way Y2 is get selected and it is connected to input. When S1 and S0 are both 1, 1, then S1 is 1, which is enabling second demultiplier and disabling first demultiplier, and when S0 is 1, it is selecting second output of second demultiplier. So hence the DIN input is get connected to the Y3. So in this way demultiplier tree works. Now let us have example of 1:16 demultiplier using 1:8 demultiplier and 1:2 demultiplier. In this example, The block diagram is, so both demultiplexer will produce totally 16 outputs. So that will fulfill our 16 output, but which are having single input. So here two inputs are there, which are connected to one more 1:2 demultiplexer. So there will be only one data input denoted as I. And we know that in 1:16 demultiplexer, we require 4 select inputs. So out of 4 select inputs, the first one is used in the 1:2 demultiplexer and remaining 3 are commonly used for both 1:8 demultiplexer. So in this design, we require 2 number of 1:8 demultiplexer and 1 1:2 demultiplexer. Here we also require 4 select inputs to select one of the 16 output. So we have here Y15 to Y0 output and single data input denoted as I. So in this way, we can construct a larger demultiplexer using smaller demultiplexer, which is known as demultiplexer tree. So these are references. Thank you.